not what Megan wore, that her hypocritical habits angered us. Hello and very happy to see you on the Sussex Daily News version 2 tonight. This video, we give you the latest backlash for Meghan Markle. Not what Meghan wore, that her hypocritical habits angered us. Today, Miss Angela Levin tweeted on Twitter, anyone else offended by Meghan referring to the royal family as the institution when she talked to Fortune magazine? And Wally replied, yes, Angela, me. She also blamed them for all her own social media interactions during her short stay with the royals. Angry fans continued, this coming from the woman who fought tooth and nail to bag the prince and become a member of the institution. Furthermore, she shamelessly uses the title gifted to her by this selfsame institution, without which she would be anonymous, invisible, and irrelevant. So passive-aggressive. I wish Meghan Markle would realize the best thing she could ever do for this entire planet is to focus on her kid and her man and stop making a fool of herself on these videos by patronizing people who could care less about her opinion. Remember the Vogue cover with many powerful and wonderful women featured but missing her own mother-in-law? A queen beyond words in influence and dignity. I am disgusted by the pair of them. The way in which they have treated Her Majesty the Queen and the royal family is appalling. Why should they be dragged through the mud by these self-absorbed grifters? They should be stripped of every title, patronage, and lines of succession and barred from the UK. This is just one of the latest outrageous reactions for Meghan Markle, and yesterday the Daily Mail reported on what Meghan Markle was wearing during the interview. They reported Meghan Markle wore a sustainable $328 dress by an African-American female designer who focuses on health of people and planet, with a $195 recycled brass earrings to discuss social media addiction at a virtual summit. Plus, appearing on the call, she swept her hair from her face into a messy side ponytail to reveal dangling $195 recycled brass earrings by female-owned jewelry brand Koyana. Tracy Reese is described online as having a reputation in the fashion industry as not only a leading talent, but a champion for diversity and inclusion. The dress is okay, and maybe nice for the beach, but not professional at all. Nice dress, but definitely not suitable attire for a summit. No doubt flogging it for financial gain, because we all know she does nothing unless she gains in one way or another. And why are people paying her to speak when she has no credibility or credentials? And she's not on social media? Yeah, right. Like most celebrities not famous for their actual craft, no, she is not a skilled actress. Everything is calculated and planned. Please don't start to pretend to care about sustainability when you fly on private jets and own a home that is so unnecessarily large. What is your power bill? If you care about sustainability, wear the same clothes over and over again. But the truth is that not many people are excited about what she wears, one commentator said. Getting dressed and talking hypocritical dross is all she can ever be bothered to do. Whoever pays to listen to her needs to get their heads checked. She is not a feminist at all, just a fame-hungry narcissist. Once she changes, then people might respect her. Another said, I could care less what Meghan wore. It's what came out of her mouth that's important. No original thoughts. All her words were from a Netflix documentary, giving no credit to the documentary. Also, I want to know how many people actually paid the $1,750. Sorry, forgot what that was in pounds, to listen to her. When are those numbers coming out? They could watch the documentary and have saved themselves a lot of money. I would demand a refund. And what does it matter if she already wore a pair of plastic pants and twice leather pants? She wears something as a token action for her fans to call her eco or sustainable or feminist, but in reality she is anything but. So many leather shoes and handbags, two or three lambskin leather skirts, leather pants. Who cares about a token dress when she is guilty of fast fashion? Only her hypocritical fans won't see the irony in that one dress out of thousands of other polyester dresses she wore. A fan also commented on Daily Mail, Meghan Markle has no class. Her dress would be okay for a cocktail party, but it's not professional. She's not a powerful woman. She's a woman who uses her feminine wiles to seduce dim-witted men a la Harry, the man-child. And she appeals to low IQ Sussex Squad bots. She plagiarized from a Netflix program about drug use and social media users. She's not honest. She's no role model for young people. It's long overdue for her to be stripped of her HRH titles and patronages, and Harry should be removed from the line of succession. Another blasted, she is being sustained by a clueless, dim-witted H and British royal family for 3 years now. She has done nothing for anyone but her own promotion, reducing handbag to less than a zero. Who's doing her makeup? Which is also being paid by the firm, as is the $35 million mansion she got for peanuts from a Russian oligarch, thanks to the royal family. The only reason why she even has a platform in the US to smirk and show off is because of the British royal family. Why else would Netflix pay anything to a Z-list has-been actress? While another user slams, after 38 years of embracing her whiteness, she is now embracing the fashionable blackness. Whatever is trending, she'll be there. Like when she embraced social media when nobody. Now it is evil and addicting. Like when she clung to Harry to give her cachet, and now he has been relegated to the basement and told to keep his trap shut. Make up your mind, you silly flibbertigibbet. And one last one added, oh please. Do you know what is sustainable and good for the planet? Buying clothes from a consignment shop or vintage store and wearing those. Give a piece of clothing a second life. Meghan doesn't care about the environment or the planet. She drives in gas-guzzling vehicles, likes to jet-set, lives in a mansion that uses gas, electric for various things, has a pool, and I bet waters the lawn in drought-prone California. She spends stupid money on stupid things for herself, not for the good of the world. Also related to fashion, let's come to another news together. Kate's still our most stylish royal. Duchess of Cambridge's wardrobe gets the most Google. Royal umbrella maker Fulton Umbrellas has analyzed Google searches related to royal style in 2020 and found that Markle was in second place after the Duchess of Cambridge. The data looked at search trends and the most popular search terms relating to the senior women of the royal family from 2017 to 2020, with Duchess of Cambridge coming out on top with 77,000 searches this year to date. Despite not carrying out engagements in person due to lockdown, Kate continued to showcase her style and opted for her usual glamorous and colorful dresses by designers such as Dolce & Gabbana and Diane von Furstenberg for video calls. However, Fulton Umbrellas registered a dip in searches relating to Meghan Markle this year. Once considered one of the least stylish members of the family, thanks to her quirky choices, Princess Beatrice secured third place with her more polished ensembles and breathtaking vintage wedding dress borrowed from the Queen. And Princess Anne came in fourth place thanks perhaps to her habit of recycling decades-old outfits, resonating with more eco-conscious shoppers. However, many fans also mocked Meghan and praised Kate. A fan wrote, Meghan Markle shouldn't be on the list. Her style is ridiculous. I mean, who wants to copy that Green Goblin outfit, for example? Catherine always looks perfectly tailored, in gowns flawless, for about half the money that Meghan Markle spent on clothes that looked like a potato sack, despite the high-end French price tag. Then again, Catherine could make even a potato sack look good. The second said, she has professional stylists for the royal way of dressing, and in the beginning, a bit too often, too short flying skirts, and the Queen ordered a more conservative dressing style. However, Meghan Markle had been too stupid using the offer by the palace for proper royal styling advice. The third added, "So much for Imelda Markle's attempts to replace Kate as the UK's style queen through her enormous expenditures of British taxpayer money on expensive couture. Kate spent a fraction of the amount. How embarrassing! Duchess Kate is a class act, respectful, educated, personable, professional, elegant, great mother, loving wife, and beautiful on the inside and out. She is a wonderful, genuine representative for both England and the Commonwealth, and a very positive role model." My news today has ended. How do you feel about it? Please leave me a comment in the comment section and we will discuss together. Don't forget to like and share my video for everyone if you think it's useful. And subscribe to the Sussex Daily News channel to get more news about the royal family. Now, good night and see you tomorrow.